snapping up Spalding stock faster than I can get my hands on it. Thought I knew who it was, but I'm not so sure. Here's an idea. You're the broker. Why don't you find out and make it fast? I have a company to take over.
All work and no play make Olivia a very dull wife.
Thank you.
Anything yet?
Well, there was a call from Tony, but that's about it. You know, if Eden's gonna make this drop, she should have been here by now.
Eden knows she has to get that shipment of antimonious to Salerno. Don't worry, she'll be here. She's probably just caught in traffic.
Either that or she's chickened out. Oh, I know you believe in the girl, but you saw the look on her face when I told her she was going to have to make this delivery. You would have thought she would have preferred jail time.
Every, the way you laid it out, you made it sound like jail time was the preferable option.
All I know is that Eden August should be here at Vinny's right now, and she's not. So what's holding her up?
Hello, hello. How are you, my son?
Good to see you. Now we have a party on our hands.
Yeah, about that. Bill came by the house earlier.
You didn't tell him. Now, I want this to be a surprise.
No, I didn't tell him, but okay. It came up.
Turns out he's been giving you the slip because he thinks you're throwing some sort of bachelor party.
So my boy's trying to weasel out in this. Well, you know, I thought something like this might happen, so I've got myself a secret weapon.
Secret weapon?
Yeah. You see, boys, now it's all in knowing your target. And I know my son just about as well as he knows that little filly that he's getting hitched to.
What's up? I thought you were out for the night.
I was, but now I'm back, so you don't have to go to the gym.
Well, I really need to work
out. You can burn off calories right here. My goodness, what do you have in this thing? It weighs a ton.
Honey, don't open that.
What? Why not?
You know, it's just stinky old gym clothes.
It's got to be tough to work out in 30-pound gym clothes. Come on.
Knock, knock.
Bill, look, it's...
Yes,
Gus.
I see. What,
hi.
What's going on?
Well, that's really up to you, actually. You can make this hard, Bill, or you can make this easy. But I need you to come with me.
That is a great idea.
Honey, you don't even know where I'm taking him yet.
Yeah, but he should go. You should go with Gus.
No, I'm sorry, Gus. I've been missing your sister all day, so I'm going to stay right here
tonight
with her.
No. She's staying here, and you're coming with me. Let's go.
Well, where are we going?
Okay, fine. I'm not supposed to tell you this, but what? If I did tell you by accident that someone's trying to throw you a surprise party, your father, and my job is to get you there, and your job is to act surprised once you arrive,
mm-hmm.
so that your old man can congratulate himself on fooling his kid, that's what I would say if it was to come out of my mouth.
Tell me this isn't a bachelor party.
Look, I know you didn't want one, but why don't you just suck it up? Suck it up, do this for your father.
You should do it. Go ahead, honey. Do this for your father.
You don't want me going to a bachelor party, especially my own. You know what happens at these things?
Oh, so why? You know what? You have fun. I trust you. Please, come on.
Eden, do you really think
that? You party hard. Okay. Have fun. I will see you later.
After you.
Out. Go. Okay. You can do this.
Okay, you know what? If she doesn't show in 10 minutes, I'm sending the troops in.
Okay. You need to relax, all right? She will be there. Hey, if I were Eden, I wouldn't be rushing in either. Because after she's done with Salerno, she's going to have to confront Bill. And then Gus. You know what he's going to do when he finds out what his sister's been up to?
Oh, so I guess it's better that he remains in denial about who his sister is.
No, he's not in denial about his sister. He just knows that she's been working hard to move past this life.
Okay. Ignorance is bliss.
Taya, I would buy myself a little ignorance right now. I keep having visions of this eager beaver cop pulling Eden over, getting an urge to check that gym bag.
Well, let them. Let them pull it over and let them check the bag, because she doesn't have anything illegal with her.
What did you say?
You heard me. What, do you think I was going to risk having those drugs hit the streets? I switched it when I went down to my car to test it.
Are you telling me that we just sent my future sister-in-law to meet a dangerous mob boss with phony drugs?
Yeah, exactly.
Are you out of your mind?
I thought you might be here.
Yeah, I just remembered I had some work I had to do, so I came back.
I thought maybe you were avoiding me.
Why would I do that? You know this job is a 24/7 commitment.
Oh, I know. I was just as devoted to it before I had my little problem. Thank goodness you offered to pitch in. Are you chairing the executive committee?
Actually, yeah, I am.
What about the regulatory compliance committee?
That too. Why?
Oh, I was just curious. But you should. They're two key committees. No, I would definitely make time for them if I were you.
Madison!
Aren't you the chair of the executive committee?
Yes!
And the regulatory compliance committee?
You're in a position to cover up all of Spalding's illegal activities, and we have a list.
No.
Let's show her to herself.
No, mm-hmm. Philip! Philip! Oh! Oh! Mm.
Tough break, honey.
Philip, kind of faded away on me there. Maybe I should call Rick. Maybe you need to go back to...
No. Never gonna happen.
No, I was just gonna say maybe you should go back on your meds.
No, honey, I feel fine. Let's get back to you.
What about me?
Well, you've been working so hard planning for the future of the family company. I'd just like to know what you have in mind.
Sign and the stock will be transferred to you. The buyer found your offer very generous.
Tell him to keep the change. Philip, sweetheart, would you hand me a pen so I can sign these?
My hands are tied.
Oh, that's right. Silly me. Be right back. All right. Here we go. We're all set.
Congratulations. Spalding Enterprises is now Spencer Enterprises.
Spencer Enterprises?
It has a nice ring to it, doesn't it? Thank you very much. Philip, wave bye-bye to the nice broker. Oh. What do I have in mind? Well, let's just say that there are a lot of exciting changes in the works.
Can't wait.
You and me both. You never told me why you're here. Did you come by to check up on me?
Do I have to? No, I was invited to a thing over at the Beacon. I thought I'd stop by on my way. Now, I have to tell you, I'm a little beat. I think I may just go on home and forget about the party.
Party?
Yeah, Billy Lewis is throwing a surprise bachelor party for his son. In your bar, as a matter of fact.
Guess the last thing your stock needs is a jolt of crummy PR. I mean, it's tanking on its own pretty badly.
You follow the Spalding share price.
Well, it's hard not to when the media's doing a story or a number on it every other day.
Not quite sure how I made the guest list, but...
What?
Maybe they felt sorry for me.
Because you're sick?
Yeah, that too. Yeah, I'm tired. I think I'm gonna do it. You coming?
You know what? I'd love to, but I have a few more hours of work here.
That's too bad. I was hoping we could spend some quality time together.
Rain check?
Okay.
I hate bachelor parties. Have you ever even been to one?
No, not really. My dad never had one.
Yeah, he doesn't really seem like the type to just get together with a bunch of friends.
I mean, he's just really picky when it comes to people.
I don't think Joey's really into this stuff at all. I mean, he was just excited to be included.
Yeah, I don't think Joey knows what he got himself into.
So, this is what guys do at bachelor parties? Just stand around?
Well, this is what guys do when the man of the hour is a no-show. I think I'm gonna check with Billy if I know what's holding up Bill. And Joey, if you're good, I'll tell you about my bachelor party.
Cool.
Ross.
So, how you doing?
I've been better. You?
I'm okay.
How about your trip to the Bower Cabin? Was that okay, too?
Yeah, look, I could totally explain that. And just to let you know, nothing happened between us.
Well, Joey, it's all right. You brought Tammy home safely, and that's all that matters. How is Tammy?
She's still mad at her mom, I guess. And you, for some reason. I really don't know the whole story.
You don't?
Well, no. I know she's mad at her mom for reading her journal, and I don't know what you did that got her so fired up.
Well, I suppose she has a reason.
All right. You ready?
No.
Oh, come on now. Come on. Your dad wanted to do this for you. Your fiancé gave you permission. What do you got to lose?
My dignity?
No, no. A couple of drinks in, that's gonna go away. Ready?
All right.
Look surprised. That's a boy.
This is unbelievable.
Don't blame me, it's all your pop.
Oh my goodness, I had no idea. I think I just wet myself as I walked through the doors. I'm serious. This is unbelievable. Thank you very much. I
say it's time we get this guy a drink, huh?
Ginger ale, right?
Sure. Dad, well, thank you. This is unbelievable. I had no idea. I've never been so surprised in my life. This is wow. Mm-hmm.
Gus told you, didn't he?
Yeah, he sure did. In fact, it's the only way he'd get me out of the house. Leave my little lady behind.
Well, look, she's got you for the rest of your life, so tonight you're mine. I'm sure Miss Eden will survive.
I am responsible for Eden. I'm the one who called you in. And now you tell me that you sent her into Salerno with fake antimonious? Do you have any idea of what could happen to her in there now?
I do know what the risks are, okay? Nothing's gonna happen. If we think that she's in any danger at all, my guys are a block away. They'll be in there before anyone knows what's going on. Harley, if Vinny decides he wants to do a little taste test, the stuff I gave her is gonna more than pass the test. Trust me. Now, Eden's gonna be long gone before Vinny realizes he's been duped. We have to play this thing out.
You wanna see how it plays out when I have to tell my fiancé that I got his sister killed?
Would you leave
that's a scenario
the family drama out of it for 1 second? Once Selena realizes the drugs are fake, what's he gonna do? He's gonna contact his supplier. His supplier, Harley, the guy whose identity we're trying to find out here, that guy.
You are still the biggest jerk.
Quiet, I hear something.
Vinny. Vinny, are you here?
You're late.
Got here as fast as I could. Have your stuff. That was not part of the deal!
Hey.
Get off of me!
Don't flatter yourself, doll. I'm just making sure it's you and me. You understand what I'm saying?
Satisfied?
Just about.
Here you go. You wanted to deliver it, you got to deliver it.
Not so fast. You're as nervous as I've ever seen you.
So?
So? It makes me wonder if something else might be going on here.
Like what, Vinny?
You tell me. And make it fast because I'm about a minute away from losing my patience. And trust me, you don't want that.
Oh, boy.
Bill, I hope it's okay with you that I'm...
That you're here? Come on, Ross. This is a nonpartisan party. No hard feelings. We talked about this at the mall.
Yeah, I know we did. I just wanted you to know that, rumors about Danny aside, I never thought you had anything to do with what happened with the vote count.
Well, thank you.
And truth be told, wish you'd been on my side.
Me too.
May I have everyone's attention? Let it be known, if it is not known already, that when my son started dating Miss Eden August, his dad was not a happy camper.
Come on now.
Now hear me out. Mm. But he saw something in her that I did not see, and he decided to listen only to himself when it came to Miss Eden August. And I have no idea where he got this kind of stubborn streak from.
No, I wonder where.
But he stuck it out, and he proved his old man wrong. And I know he's just dying to say, I told you so.
Well, I told you so.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to say that I think she's going to make a hell of an addition to the Lewis clan. I say congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks. Yeah, I guess this is where I got to say a few words, huh?
Yeah. Yep.
Can I go home now?
You just sit still. The entertainment is about to arrive. I'm sure she is outside this door at this very minute.
Hey, Billy, is this a private party, or can you just come on in and crash it if you have your name on the wall?
Step right in.
What's going on with you? Guest of honor, don't have a drink in his hand. Come on, boys. What kind of party are you throwing him?
Honey, I thought you said you had a few more hours of work to do.
If I didn't know better, I'd think you were afraid to be alone with me.
Hey, pal. Hey, why aren't you at Bill Lewis's bachelor party? Oh. Well, see, that's why I didn't go to med school. All that suffering and then more suffering. No, I'm still at the office. I just finished up a few things. No, actually, I like it at night. It's quiet. I get a lot done. Listen, I wanted to see. Do you want to hook up later for a while? There's something I'd like to run by you. No, I don't think I feel like waiting until 3 o'clock. No, it's all right. You know what? It's not a big deal. I'll talk to you about it tomorrow. Yeah, that's fine. Great. I'm Alex. Hi.
Well, this is a surprise, and you are looking...
lucid? Alert? Well-dressed? What?
All of the above, darling, and it is so good to see you in this office. You have been sorely missed.
Well, perhaps by you and Alan. I have a feeling not by its current occupant.
Oh, don't worry. You'll have this office back in no time at all. As soon as this ridiculous investigation is finally over, you will be right back where you belong.
And Olivia?
Oh, I have a nice, quiet little cozy spot picked for her.
Really?
Yes, it's down in the boiler room. Well, what, darling? Really, she'll get all that exercise going up and down those stairs.
Aunt Alex, one of the many things that I have always adored about you, you always have a plan.
And you're saying you don't?
Nervous? Maybe that's because of all the things that you could have had
me delivered to you tonight. You went and picked illegal drugs. What happened to nice, harmless counterfeiting, Vinnie, huh? Or importing endangered lizards? Why'd you have to go and make me your drug runner?
Because that's what I needed you to be.
You scared the living daylights out of me. When I looked in that package and I saw what I had to bring to you, I was looking in my rearview mirror every 2 seconds, Vinny. I'm getting married, Vinny. Soon. I do not want to have to change my wedding to cell block B.
Be here now. That's all that counts, isn't it?
We're done. You gave me my last job, and I pulled it off. So excuse me.
I don't think so. What do you think? One pickup and delivery, that's it?
But then you told me I was done.
You're mine. You know that saying, when you love something, you let it go?
Yeah.
I don't buy it. You're gonna do whatever I want you to do. For as long as I want you to do it, you understand? I own you. So we're not done. Until I say we're done. Okay. Now we're done.
believe it. I'm actually having fun.
Me too.
Mm. What's it take going home these days? It doesn't feel like home.
Really?
Not for me. I couldn't wait to walk through that door, which my entire life, I hated living in that house. Yeah. But now, I have to tell you, now it's home. Or I'm just getting old.
Oh, hardly, dear. Come on.
And you know what it is? I think my kids are enjoying growing up there more than I did. I found James and Zach down in the pantry today. They were stealing cookies, but they told me that they were taking them for their new little sister.
Mm-hmm.
Good. I'm not quite sure their motives were quite that pure.
Well, you have wonderful children, Philip.
I do. I give their mothers all the credit.
Oh, and a beautiful new little girl. I always wanted a daughter.
That would have been great.
Mm-hmm. Raise any child would have been great, period.
It is. I'm sorry you had that taken from you. I know you miss being a mother.
Heavens, I still am a mother. I talk to Nick. What, regularly? Just not the same, though.
I know you still miss Lou Jack.
Yeah, that never changes. And every time I try to go to a quiet place, his face pops up in front of me. It says, "Hi, Mom, how you doing?" "Fine. I want you to be happy." So you do, you get on with it. That's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to get on with life. Yeah, I miss him. Every day. That never goes away. Listen, darling, I think you're forgetting you're supposed to be somewhere.
There is no place I would rather be. Although there is a bachelor party.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I know.
Bill Lewis is having a bachelor party. I actually may pop by there on the way home, or I may not.
Bud said he was going to pop in himself
at
some point. Yeah.
Well, maybe I better go then. You know, somebody's always got to look out for Bud.
We're all right. He wasn't very enthusiastic about it, and I don't know why.
Well,
I mean, he likes Bill, but...
I'll tell you a little secret on it. Most men actually hate bachelor parties. They do.
Really? Mm-hmm. Well, then I'll tell you a little secret, my dear. I've crashed a few of those bachelor parties in my day, and for the most part, they were very disappointing.
There you go.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know how I got invited to this. You know, Bill and I are not exactly friends, and we became even less so when he was seeing Beth.
You know, Beth is looking absolutely wonderful these days.
Mm.
And Lizzie's doing so much better. You're home. I mean, Beth is looking very especially wonderful
these
days.
Don't even think about it. I'm a married man.
Of course you are, dear. Nothing wrong with having a backup plan, is there, just in case?
You know, I don't think Beth would appreciate being thought of as my backup plan.
Of course not. What about a permanent plan, permanent solution? Well, you can't blame a girl for dreaming, can you, dear? Hmm? You two so belong together.
I have to live in the present. I have a little daughter that I have to take care of. And who knows? Maybe we'll all just live together as one big happy family. Stranger things have happened.
Name one.
I hope you don't mind that I crashed Bill's bachelor party.
Well, frankly, I'm kind of glad to have somebody of the female persuasion here, because I think my stripper's a no-show.
Oh. Well, I came here to toast Bill, not get him all hot and bothered.
You know, actually, I think he'd like that better, because he's kind of a reluctant participant in tonight's events.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm kind of surprised by that.
Oh, yeah? How's that?
There's a lot of things he does surprises me.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, the other day he was telling me that he was a novice in the stock market, and I would have pegged him for a player, or at least someone with some knowledge of things.
Oh, darling, he's shocking you. I mean,
what?
He's a whiz. Oh, yeah, he trades more stocks before 10 o'clock than most people trade in a year.
You're kidding me.
Oh, it's true. Look, I got to circulate. I'm, you know, I'm the only entertainment, you know?
Mine.
Wait, Lizzie, hold up.
What? I thought you wanted to go in there. Come on.
Yeah, but not like this.
What? This is the best idea, okay? I can't believe I didn't think of it before now. Okay, take a room full of guys partying. Can you bring in a camera phone?
We're gonna have more fun than we're doing now, right? They're probably half drunk by now anyway. They're not gonna care if we take pictures. But yeah, there's some great champagne too.
Yeah, but we're not old enough to drink it.
Have I taught you nothing?
Lizzie, let's just go run some movies or something. This is too weird.
Tammy, I'm going in there with or without you.
Without.
Okay, so, you know, if Joey's in a lap dance or something, I'll just take a picture of it for you. Okay, yeah, let's go in. You know what? I've seen enough. Fine, suit yourself.
Well, if it isn't Lizzie Spaulding.
I thought that the only women at these parties were supposed to be jumping out of cakes and whatnot.
Ah, me too. Apparently, we were misinformed. Let's go see if Lizzie's lost.
I'll tell you what, seem awfully interested in Lizzie Spaulding. You like her?
I like everybody. I told you, I'm a student of human nature.
All right, well, why don't you go study Lizzie a little more, and I'll go refresh my beverage.
So, hey, Lizzie, you take a wrong turn somewhere?
Oh, haha. Very funny, Sandy.
Why are you here? You looking for your stepmom?
Oh, great. You know, I go home, she's there. I come out to get away from her, and she's here too, so, you know.
You know, Aunt Olivia, it's not so bad. And she'd be a great person to talk to about your summer project.
Yeah, my summer project. What, you think I'm just gonna do it because you came up with this idea?
No, I think you're gonna do it because it's a good idea.
What's a good idea?
About anything Sandy comes up with.
Well, what's going on?
I'm on an assignment.
An assignment?
Yes, get together, boys. Smile.
Oh. Well, well.
Olivia.
Ross.
Imagine meeting you at Olivia's.
Oh, come on. Well, you saw me come in, right?
Oh, yes, I did. It's hard to miss. Say, how is my nephew doing now that he's out of the hospital?
He's fine. He's doing great, actually. You know, I haven't had a chance to congratulate the soon-to-be ex-bachelor, so if you'll excuse me.
Oh, yeah.
Hey.
Olivia, I'm sorry. No. I was just looking at the thing.
I know. Do you have a second? I hope you don't mind that I sort of barged in here, but, you know, that
you
is my
did
name.
Barge in here, but yeah, that's okay, but I'm the man of the hour here, and I probably got
to
make the
rounds.
But I need to talk to you. Don't
I think you need to sit down before you fall down,
sit
right?
Sit down? Well, come here. You know something about Lewis men?
What?
We hold the liquor.
We do.
I don't think that's right. That's right. That's right.
You need a chair.
Yeah, I think I do.
Uh-huh. I'll show you where mine is. Come on.
There you go. Mind taking it easy with the equipment, please?
Oh, I'm sorry. People are disposable, but the equipment we have to handle with kid gloves.
Is there a problem?
No, but there could have been. You should be grateful that Eden got out of there okay. Are you crazy? Sending her into Vinnie Salerno with a supply of fake drugs?
She's out, okay? She's out now, and she's safe, okay? So get over it.
Listen to me, O'Neill. Things could have turned out very differently in there. You know it.
Well, they could have, but they didn't. The one who took the risk was Eden to begin with by getting involved with that guy.
Did you hear what he said to her? He makes it sound like she's going to be his slave for the rest of her life.
She should have thought of that when she first got involved with him. You don't get out of a life like that that easily. Fact of the matter is, she did come through for us, right? Thanks to Eden August, we've got ourselves the first nail in Vinnie Salerno's coffin.
guess we better be heading on home, huh?
I'm gonna let you go ahead, and I will be right behind you, okay?
All right, darling.
Clean this mess up and finish up a few last-minute things, and I'll be on my way.
Oh, Philip, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for spending some time with me.
Hey. It was my pleasure.
Yeah.
I'll see you home.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see what Tokyo is doing with my stock. My stock has been sold? Uh-huh. She used my power of attorney. Of course she did. I'll be damned. Okay, honey. Let's see what's in your portfolio. Oh, yeah? My access is denied? All right. My darling wife. Just what the hell are you up to now?
Perfect. Okay, so do you think you can, throw a bottle at that sign, maybe? Please?
No, that'd be called vandalism.
Lizzie, you can plot against Olivia on your own time. We're sober, remember?
Yeah, some bachelor party, all soda and no girls.
Hey, I'm a girl and I'm here.
Yeah, I gotta go catch up with my dad.
All right, look, I'm coming with you.
Whoa. What's the rush?
Well, I don't know. How'd you get in here anyway?
I walked in. No one stopped me.
Is Tammy lurking out there with you?
Tammy, no, I haven't seen her.
It's too bad. Would have been nice to, have her out there while you were plotting to come in here. That way, maybe I could have been hanging out with her tonight.
Yeah, well, too bad. You're stuck with me. So, why don't you tell me everything I missed? Come on.
Well, quite the party, isn't it?
Bored out of my mind. I wish I was home with my girl.
Me too. Well, care to play a hand?
I'm playing solitaire.
I thought we might have a game of Go Fish. No? All right. Red Jack on Black Queen. Mr. O'Neill, I'm quite surprised you were invited to this party.
Actually, I just came in for a drink.
Hard day work, destroying more lives?
Well, what can I say? I must have found my calling.
If only it weren't in Springfield.
Message. You got my message.
I was tied up, Jeffrey, yeah. Business.
Yeah, I know. Please, don't even tell me. I can't wait for this drug stuff to be over with.
Yeah, me too. So, isn't this Bill's party?
Yeah.
So where is he?
Oh, please, he's been hitting the bottle. People are feeding him drinks.
So you're saying he skipped out of his own bachelor party?
No, I don't know. Maybe Billy let him off the hook, and he didn't want to be here in the first place. Maybe his dad put him in a cab. Wait a minute, where'd everybody go?
We left the party, remember? You had too much to drink, you didn't want to embarrass yourself.
You telling me I said all that?
You sure did.
Well, I must be more sober than I am.
Then you what? Then you what?
I don't remember what I was going to say.
It's okay. It's okay. Why don't you sit down?
Where?
Right over there. Anywhere. You know, it's really a kick scene like this.
Huh?
Usually you're so together, so on top of your game, business, and life. You're a pretty savvy guy, Bill. And I'm sure once we get some coffee in you, you'll just dazzle me
coffee,
with your brilliance.
No coffee.
Come on, you're
no
a brilliant coffee. Guy, I'm sure that you never let an opportunity slip through your fingers. Like the stock market, for instance. I'm sure you play, I play. Bill, if we pool our resources.
Yeah.
Bill?